Hello everyone and welcome to a new IBMI RPG and SQL sample video. Sometimes we need to delete records from a table, but that table has a trigger. We can do it by simply removing the trigger from the table, then deleting the records and then adding the trigger again. But also in these cases, we can do everything easily using a single operation. Today I show you an example of how to use Truncate. Let's go. Today we're going to use our friend Run Scripts utility. Well, let me show you the content of the table that I'm going to use in the example. It's my table named Games. As you can see, we have four rows inside the table, okay? Well, a few days ago, I put a trigger on this table. The trigger stores information in another table when updating or deleting a record. The table where I stored the information is this. If you want to know how to set the trigger, I suggest you watch the video where I created using SQL. Okay, now let's delete the data from the table. But if we use delete from, then each deleted record will save data in my history. I don't want anything to be saved. So for that, we're going to use truncate. With truncate, we can delete all records in a table, also preventing any trigger that this table has from being executed. This statement also allows me to indicate if I want the records to be deleted, ignoring the trigger, or to return an error if the trigger exists. For example, we can write truncate the name of the table, and then I can write restrict when delete triggers. If I run this, I will get an error. And I'm getting an error because the table has a trigger on the delete operation. For deleting the records, we can ignore the options or we can write this truncate ignore delete triggers. Okay, we can write it this way or just this way. Okay, it is the same. If we run this, okay, now let me see the content of my file, of my table. The table is empty, and also if I see my history, as you see, I don't have any operations saved for today. Well, as you see, this is a very good option to avoid removing and adding a trigger when we need to remove records from a table that has a trigger. I hope you liked the video and that it was useful to you. As always, remember to like and subscribe if you aren't already. See you on the next video. Thanks for watching.